It's traditionally known as Mad Monday, but today it was very much Magpie Monday. The Collingwood players continuing their premiership party with a variety of guises, which included a dinosaur, an F1 driver, and one from our own newsroom. Braden Ingram explains.
Wacky, weird, mad. This Monday had it all.
You look sore, mate.
No, I'm worse than sore.
From the Peaky Blinders to Lewis Hamilton, Coxzilla, and even our very own Tony Jones.
On you, TJ.
The premiership pies chomping at the bit to keep the party going. Surprise packet Oleg Markov making light of the single day he spent in Carlton's setup.
What could have been? We'll never know.
Craig McRae told Jack Ginnivan to read the room after his questionable visit to Moonee Valley on grand final eve. He didn't get the message. Today, dressed as a jockey. By now, everyone was hoarse.
Yeah, really good. Obviously, the voice is it's gone, but, yeah, amazing.
Far from punching above his weight, Scott Penderbury took to imitating UFC fighter Conor McGregor. The club's windfall from this premiership will be monumental. As you can see, the shop is packed, every item hot property, and only 48 hours after lifting the cup, already merchandise sales are in excess of a whopping $3 million. It also pays to be in the tattoo game. Son Jamie and dad Paul among many sporting fresh ink.
He said, if we win, I'm taking you straight to the tattooist and we're going to get a tattoo. And I said, Mum's going to kill me.
Emotions running high for all who bleed black and white, including past coach and captain Nathan Buckley.
Like openly sobbing at the final siren.
The Pies reign just beginning, but Gillon McLaughlin's is finally over. This his final day in charge of League HQ, but not before trumpeting his call on the grand final entertainment.
I think, you know, there were a few doubters. In a year later, Kiss has had 50% more social interactions than Robbie Williams already. So someone liked them, or everyone seemed to love them.
And with that, it was Kiss and goodbye. Braden Ingram, Nine News.
For the Brisbane Lions, they'd had a little more time to let the loss sink in. And while there was still pain, there was also pride. At Springfield, there was a carnival-like atmosphere as the team got a chance to thank the loyal fans who've cheered them on the whole way.
At the Springfield home of the Brisbane Lions, loyal fans gathered on the ground to welcome home their team.
Win, lose, draw, we love the boys regardless. They put up a great fight.
A great fight, a great grand final, sadly not the great victory. But this Lions team remain the pride of Brisbane town.
So Lions fans have found their voices.
Yeah.
And we were loud and we were proud.
So proud of the boys. We are so proud. They have done our whole state proud, and second is nothing to be ashamed of.
The players presenting on the balcony. Today, their chance to say thank you to the fans who cheered them all the way.
Thank you so much for coming today. Thank you so much for us.
After such a roller coaster week, today is all about celebrating, and it's also about hope as to what this team can do in 2024.
Brisbane Lions will kick the winning score.
The main thing is that you never give up, you keep chasing it. And this group's a young group and there's plenty of football still left in them.
For hours, the players chatted and signed merchandise.
I'm pretty excited to get my stuff signed by all the players from the Brisbane Lions.
Footies, flags, posters, even a pooch.
Sign your dog.
As Lions legends, Lion Cubs and Lion Kings commemorated a season worth celebrating.
Yeah, obviously, we're disappointed loss, but yeah, it's good to put a smile on people's faces and come out here and sign some autographs and get some photos. But yeah, like I said, got a few days to recover now and then rebuild and go again for next year.
Next year, when you better believe you'll find these fans back in full voice.
Take me home, country road.
Jessica Millward, Nine News.